Hi everybody, my name is Maxime Chagnot. I'm a CATIA engineer working for PLM Group in Norway, and today I will show you how we can make a basic drafting of an assembly in 3DEXPERIENCE. Let's see. Okay, so first thing, I will search for my assembly. So I can select my content, and then I will see everything that belongs to my assembly, to my 3DEXPERIENCE platform. And what I like to do maybe is to search the root option. So if I click on more tag, then I can select root here, and this will only show me every root assembly I have. So we can open this one like this. It will open it in CATIA Assembly Design. Okay. And now we will make a drafting. So I will insert, as you can see in the top assembly here, I will go to insert and I will create a drawing. And I will call this drawing assembly block and axle and click on OK. My drawing has been created now, so I can double click on it and it will open in a different tab from the original one. And now we are in CATIA drafting. And the very first thing you want to do is to bring a front view. So I can go to front view and select the view I want. Okay, so as you can see, the sheet is a bit too big, but we can modify it after. The more important here is you have selected the right angle. And I'm not completely satisfied here. I want maybe to turn it that angle. Click on the background, and when it's done, now the view is generated. You cannot modify it from there, but you can make another view. For example, projection view, like this. And we can even make more by creating an offset view. So we see here that this is red and this is blue. So we are active on this view here. So if I click on offset view, I will go above the axis and now double click, and I have an offset view here. We can continue just by modifying the size of the sheet. So we can go to page layout, and this is ISO standard, and we can maybe put an A4. Let's see. A4 might be a bit too small. Click on OK. Yeah, A4 is a bit too small, so we can just put A3. A3 ISO, we want it as landscape, okay. And now we can even add some dress up. So we can put original dress up, instantiate. Oh, no template. So I will select this one and create, apply. This one is automatically from Dassault system. So when you click on OK, you have already one created from there. And the way you can modify that is to go on the sheet background. So if you want to do that, you need to go in the view and edit sheet background. Now you are black, and now we can modify the text here. Like so. And I can just double click to go back, edit sheet to go back to the original mode. Last one I want to show you is the view we can create. It's called isometric. If you select isometric here, it will not necessarily have an isometric view. It will just show you a snapshot of this angle here. So if I click here, we have a view, but it's not completely isometric, because isometric means that you have 120 degrees between each angle here, and this is not the case. So we'll delete this view first, okay? Go back to the assembly, and this is very easy to swap between these two. Now go to view and select the correct view, and to do so, we need to go to, here. We can either select the view selector to swap, or we can select ISO, and I have the correct isometric view. So I can go back to my drafting, select isometric, go back to my assembly and select this view. This view is now isometric. It would be nice also if this view have some color, and to do that, you can go to properties of this view and go to generation. We can have 3D color apply, but this is only the edge. So it's not really nice. Maybe we want to have a raster mode with high quality and shading with edges. High quality. And now you will get kind of a pixel, a JPEG picture, I mean. And this is nice because I can see my assembly in 3D, but it's a bit too big. So I will just minimize this view. And I can go to view here, and we want to have maybe 1/5 in the scale. And now we can put it on the corner. Like that. Or even bigger if you feel like it. You can just go back here and modify. Yes, like that. And now my drafting is really good. I can just save it. And go back to my assembly. And obviously, if you want to do some modification here, you can do it, update, save, and double click on the drawing to do the modification from there. So this is very robust and very flexible. So that was it for me today. Thank you very much and have a nice day.